concrete and fucking neon lights and shit.
Fuck, cool though. Man, I love Infamous.
I wish they weren't console exclusives though.
Yeah. But you can probably get an emulator.
What, for PlayStation 4?
In the future, you can get an emulator for PlayStation 4. So I thought it was a PS3 game, sorry.
Well, I think even PS3s don't have emulators yet.
Yeah.
And even if they did, they would be incredibly bad.
Yeah.
What you do, okay, is you go forward 10 years, you download it, and you come back. Dumbass.
Do you? Look, you know what you could do? Is go down to the used store and buy a used PS3 for like $25.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's a much better idea, actually. Never mind fucking time travel. If you're at that point, you might as well just wish for money.
Did you know, guys, that I can actually
time travel, steal money, and then go back in time?
Yeah, I can...
forward in time, steal money from yourself when you're rich. And then go back.
Oh, that paradox. No, I can time travel back in time, but I can only do irrelevant things that are completely pointless. Like, I can go back in time to before McDonald's shot, for example.
Before what?
Before McDonald's shot and order myself a burger.
Listen, that's a pretty useful power.
Is it?
Really? That is, yeah.
Fucking Justice League, they're all sitting around their fucking Justice Tower in space and they're like, shit, what are we going to eat tonight?
And Chinese, McDonald's.
Everything shut
down. And they're like, oh shit, it's all closed. Like, backwards in time to inconvenient places, boy. It's all like, don't worry, guys.
Oh, God.
I got this.
Oh, we've made the best Justice League there. Remember last time we were talking about Just Too Late Man or whatever his name was?
Yeah.
Everything
oh my God,
he did,
just
he was
too late,
just
man.
Too late.
And goes back in time to,
there's
like,
such
not really
a great
useful
pair.
Things.
Yeah.
They work together.
And was it Eat Too Much Boy or whatever it was?
Eats Too Much.
Oh yeah, no, it was Little Too Much Boy.
He walks around the Justice Tower like, whoa, whoa, guys.
That's why he was called.
Like, did you eat too much again? He's like, no, no.
I think his name was actually Little Too Much, but he didn't do anything in moderation.
Nothing in moderation, boy. It's like addicted to cocaine.
Oh, Jesus.
Pointless back in time, boy. I don't know.
No, it's travel back in time a little bit to do something not that useful, boy.
The very specific power.
What about what would be the best, most useless power?
Oh, I know.
Automatically power. Rewinds the tapes, boy, because we don't even use tapes anymore.
How about impervious to damage from sponges, boy?
What if you dropped a huge sponge on him?
He wouldn't take any damage.
Then that would be useful.
Well, shit, that'd be like a shining moment.
Yeah.
When like this, the bit bad guy's like gonna drop a gigantic sponge on the city, and then impervious as sponges boy is just like, I got this one. Except he just sort of stands in the middle of the city and emerges from the rubble fine,
yeah.
Like everyone else is dead.
No, what would happen is like, you know, it's like New York, right? So there's all these skyscrapers. So he's the bad guy's like, I'm going to drop it. And then he drops it and it like lands on the top of the skyscrapers and just kind of stays up there. Yeah.
It lands in the bay, like
all the water gets
sucked out. Yeah.
Yeah.
What was your suggestion, Evil, for a silly power? I can't remember what you said now.
I can't remember. Did I have a silly power?
I think you said something.
How about heats up pizza but only to a lukewarm temperature, boy?
Fucking, oh god, the League of, what did I call it? League of, like, stupid superheroes or whatever it was.
The League of Unextraordinary Gentlemen.
They're all ladies.
It's a bit of a misnomer.
Look, the website was available, so they went for it, okay?
The website, yeah. Gotta get those domains, man.
Yeah. How about can't hold it in, boy? I don't know.
He just wheeze himself all the time?
And burps. And pukes.
Oh my god. Lives a life of misery. Poor guy.
Like that conversation we had, would you rather hiccup forever or like, was it sneeze forever?
I really wouldn't want
just
both.
Just neither, you know? Just like, these are horrible. I hate, like, I'd run away. I'd do what Corey does. I'd run away.
No, Corey, you can't do that. No, I can.
Oh, did King Cobra friend you in the end, by the way?
Yeah.
Cool. Anyone joining the stream right now will be like, what the fuck are you guys talking about? Superheroes? What?
Yeah, the best superheroes. The most useful superheroes.
The Ineffectual Superhero League.
Of America.
Of America.
of North America. Just like randomly, it also covers Canada and Mexico. But the rest of the world is... they're screwed.
Do you think, like... If there's... like a big bad villain, and he's like blowing shit up in just on the other side of Trump's border wall.
Yeah.
You know, the Justice League of America's like, well, side of our jurisdiction, it'll resolve itself, I'm sure.
They get like the shitty Mexican superheroes to try and solve it.
I think there is a Captain Mexico.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, I remember.
It's probably like super racist. He's got like a sombrero.
There's totally like a... no, there is a Captain Canada, because Birdie was talking about him.
Oh yeah.
But he's not called Captain Canada. He's like,
I thought it was
something
else. A lady.
I think there's a man and a lady.
Captain Canada. Let's see. Oh shit.
It's got his fucking maple leaf and everything.
Yeah, maple leaf on the shield. It's pretty sweet actually.
Yeah. There's also a Captain Britain. I wonder where it stops.
Captain Canuck.
Captain Britain.
Captain Britain. That's
How about we call them the International Society of Ineffectual Superheroes?
Oh shit. How about the Intergalactic Society?
But
none of them can travel in space.
Okay. But just... did you see what the acronym spells out?
Oh, what does it spell? It should spell the same thing.
The International Society of Ineffectual Superheroes.
Do you think the Intergalactic Society of Heroes that can't
ISIS
actually go into a... what?
Nice.
I figured, why not call them ISIS?
Wait, what are they called again?
The International Society of Ineffective Superheroes.
Oh my god, that's hilarious. Holy shit.
Thought you'd like that.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I'd love to get like
works,
one of those Google Chrome plugins that change words and just change every occurrence of ISIS to International Society of Ineffectually Superheroes. you just have to keep trying lol Jesus nah.
And unless you're getting
I feel
the...
like I just said something backwards.
Yeah. Unless you're getting the error where it says downloading map, in which case what you need to do is disconnect from the internet, load up Pro, and then reconnect to the internet again, and then log in.
But don't disconnect from the internet. Keep watching us. It's fun.
Yeah, keep watching us.
It's a good time.
Don't touch that dial.
You could do that, but don't.
Either that, or you've got a queue, in which case you got to wait like 20 minutes like we did or whatever.
Ah, oh, shit, this picture's too big.
I wonder if he's still here, but yeah, the fix for that is just internet. What's up, Jake?
Nothing.
It's too big. What? Nothing. It's too big, woman.
I just said this picture is too big.
Alright.
Last bone is too big.
Do you have Star U on you?
Yeah, I do. I deliberately brought her with me.
Oh, shit. What am I gonna trade for it? What do you want? Because I've probably got some stuff that you don't have that might be.
Oh right.
Hard to get.
Sure.
I'll take a look.
We're trading back again anyway, aren't we? So.
I suppose so.
I haven't got a Bulbasaur or Charmander or anything like that.
Yeah, but I've only got like Charizard and Blastoise and stuff, and I want to use my Bulbasaur. I want to level it up.
All right.
Do you have Charlizard?
Charlizard.
Charlizard.
Charlizard!
What else am I missing? Fucking Charlizard. I don't have a shoulder. I don't
Dinks
have...
Dinks is fucking impossible to catch. What is this bullshit? I can't believe this. I'm fucking being screwed in the butt here.
What?
You heard him.
I'm trying to find a Pokemon that you can give me. Okay, Jesus.
No, I'm not... Fuck you, I'm not giving it to you. I'm giving it to myself.
We're swapping him back again. A Lapras, a Pinsir, a Gyarados...
Oh, any I can give you a pincer.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because that's like something that doesn't evolve, though. That's fine.
Well, you're going to get the pincer back again when you've finished evolving your Staryu, whatever, aren't you?
Yeah, I know, but the thing is, like, you know, it'd be kind of dumb if I gave you a Bulbasaur, because you'd have to get one yourself anyway, if you wanted to get, like, Ivysaur and Venusaur. Yeah. The pincer is fine, because he doesn't evolve. But he's rare anyway.
I'll just keep him warm for you until you finish evolving that Staryu.
I came all the way down here to see Foam. And I want to get the Jinx, you know, I want a little memento, a little souvenir, you know? I want a little slave girl that I can bring back.
It hasn't appeared yet then, Jinx.
You know, just a souvenir.
You cannot call Jinx a slave girl, especially because of its, you know... purple face.
Oh yeah, that's funny. Well, wasn't her face originally black, but they changed it to purple?
Yes.
Oh my god, that reminds me of the fucking Smurfs. Listen, there's black Smurfs, okay? I don't care what anybody... Let no man nor woman tell you otherwise, but there are black Smurfs. And they, yes. And it's the fucking best thing to come out of Smurfs ever because, look, there's this one episode, I think I talked about this before, with the black Smurfs in it. And it's so, like, bizarre. Because the way, black Smurfs are zombie Smurfs, basically. If a black Smurf bites you, you turn into one. So it's a zombie, infection or virus or whatever. That
Bluffs?
Whole episode played out just like a zombie apocalypse movie. It was incredible. I couldn't believe it when I watched it again. It was
the thing
exactly
is,
like
this
a
episode doesn't
movie.
Exist. It's just an evil's head.
Because no. Because it starts off with like patient zero, and he comes in time. More and more people are getting taken over, and like they're fucking. They find a cure. And they start curing them, but they can't cure them fast enough. People are getting bit faster than they can be cured, and like, it all comes to a head, and like, Papa Smurf's like the last Smurf left, and he gets bitten, and then all the Smurfs are black Smurfs, and it's like, oh my god, no way, it's the end. Yeah, but then like, Papa Smurf the cure, whatever, falls into the fire. And so it, like, creates a smoke cloud and rains down on everyone.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Papa Smurf used the Heart of the Cards and broke against the curse.
And then he unleashed Exodia onto the...
yeah.
And Dark Magician.
Yeah, I'm looking it up on Wikipedia. You're right. It does exist.
Of course it fucking exists.
Isn't
but
it?
They changed them all to purple Smurfs because they're like, oh, it's racist.
Isn't there one where it's like, run away from the black guys or something?
Yeah, but the thing is, like, I'm looking at the picture of it, and the black Smurfs do look quite evil and menacing, because they're, like, actually pitch black, like, totally black.
Yeah, they're kind of scary.
Because everyone knows anyone who's black is evil.
That's right. But,
anyone
like,
who just tuned
guys,
in,
they're not evil.
I'm so sorry.
But yeah, it's interesting, actually, looking at this, because the original story of the black Smurfs was published in 1958. That's how old that is.
19 what?
Oh, yeah.
And 1958, whoa. It was before, like, the zombie sort of idea was around.
Oh my god, you're right.
So it was like the first zombie thing.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh man, Smurfs is awesome.
Also, by the way, LOL uses NA left, so he might have gone offline.
Okay.
I know, just letting you know.
I mean, I don't really care. I don't really give two shits. LOL uses nah.
How about Snorts Milkman?
Oh shit, that's an important person right there. Snorts Milkman.
That's not even like... These aren't even powers anymore. I'm Snort Milk.
Listen to
Heiach,
me.
I have confession to make. Listen to me, please. I am Snort's Milkman.
Secret identity.
I don't mean he like gets lines of milk and like a straw and snorts it. What I mean is that whenever he like laughs or giggles, like milk comes out of his nose.
Ew.
So he can't help but snort milk.
That's disgusting. That's horrible. Nobody wants to be his friend. He's not in the League of Super Friends.
He's in the League of Super Gross Dudes. You would never have to milk a cow again. Just use his nose.
I wouldn't drink milk from a man's nose.
It's nose milk. It's good for you.
Heiach, when you were wee, did you ever watch a show called, like, Going Round the Twist or something?
Have you ever had a thought like this? Strange things happen. Are you going round? Yes.
I kind of hate that show because it's so weird. It's like... It's so weird. It's really weird. And there's, like, some really disgusting stuff in it. Like this one episode where the brother can, what is it, dispense like milkshakes and hot chocolate from his nose?
Oh, really? They drink it? I thought I made it up.
It's fucking nasty. And then another episode where like they're just getting bird shat on. Like loads of it. Just, they go in this little cabin and all these seagulls come in like shit to the cabin. It's fucking caked in. It's like a fucking snow day. It's nasty. I hate that show.
Oh my god.
It's disgusting.
I've just googled image search this.
Yeah.
Round the Twist bird poop.
Yeah.
And it does look pretty nasty. If that's the one, if that picture is from it. Like, it looks like they're just covered in icing.
Yeah.
Hey, is that it?
Yeah.
Guys, Murkrow's got a friend.
There's old Murkai?
There's another player here called Bex, and she's also training up Murkrow in the cave. Have a friend!
Old Murkai.
Old Murkai.
Yeah. You know, from,
Did he manage to get in yet, by the way, online games? Of course he has. I just traded with him. I'm a dumbass. Fucking idiot. Did he manage to get in, the person that I traded with? Fucking hell. I'm special. How about can I be in the Super League? Can I be in there too? I'll be Say's dumb shit man. No matter the situation, we'll always say something dumb. Yeah, ignore me, online gamers. I was being stupid. You guys still there? Has TeamSpeak died?
No, we're all dead.
Okay.
We were eating black smurfs.
Round the Twist.
Don't mention it. Did they have a name for the Black Smurfs, by the way? Did they call them Blurfs?
Yeah, they were just Black Smurfs. Yeah, look, oh my god, this is fucking it. Look at this fucking thing.
What is it? You have to show us.
Round the Twist.
No, I just...
Oh, the Black Smurf panel. I'll link it for chat.
A Black Smurf. Smurf for your lives.
Why is he saying...
He'll bite us and we'll all turn black. Smurf for it.
But why is he saying Nash Nash? He's not Nasher from, like, Dennis the Menace?
Yeah, he is. That's...
All right.
He's going... Rah, rah. That's what Nash Nash means.
Nash Nash. Run away, you'll turn black too, and that'll be horrible.
Look, it's not that he's black, it's that he's like a zombie.
Alright, okay, fine.
It just so happens that you also get colored black.
So, I mean, we can let the subject die, but I want before we end the subject, I want Jake to come up with an idea for a superhero.
What? A good one or a bad one?
A bad
come
one.
Come up with a whole bunch.
A bad one. Have you? Like?
I don't know.
Indecisive man.
Nah, that's too boring. He has to like have a very specific thing that he can do or can't do.
like immune to damage from sponges, man. It's like, what the fuck?
Yeah, how would he even discover that? Because like, does a sponge ever damage you?
As a child, he was playing dodgeball with like those sponge balls that you play with sometimes. Do you guys remember them from school?
Yeah, I remember those.
And he'd get hit in the head with them and they wouldn't hurt.
But like, they don't hurt.
Shut up.
Anyway.
Okay, look. He was in an accident in like a sponge factory, okay, and it blew up, but he didn't die.
Poor guy. He should have died.
He should have died.
Nothing is worth that. Having to go through your whole life without being able to be damaged by sponges.
Yeah. Trying to think of a really, really bad power, like can't untie shoelaces, man, or something. I don't know. He just always has Velcro shoes on.
Velcro shoes.
Remember Velcro back from like the 80s?
You only ever see Velcro shoes on little kids and old people.
Yeah.
You ever notice that? Old people are just like, look, I just don't care anymore.
I can't be asked.
When I was wee, when we went shoe shopping, I was getting new shoes. I always requested my shoes had to have two things. Had to. I would not get shoes otherwise.
Can I guess?
One, they would be Velcro. All right?
Okay.
Were you gonna guess?
I was gonna guess.
I was gonna
pink
guess
and girls.
Yeah.
Pink and girly.
How did you know?
It wasn't two, light up, right? Like those are expensive.
Fucking, yeah.
Light up. Yeah, like so.
It had to have little fucking LEDs in it.
Yeah. And they were powered by like you walking.
I don't know if they were. They weren't. It was.
Or I guess
it was
it probably
just
had a little
battery. Yeah, it just had a little battery.
But like
they
were
had
activated.
No way to replace it. So once it ran out, that was it.
Yeah.
It's like when you had those platform shoes of goldfish in. No way to replace the goldfish when it died.
Oh yeah.
Oh my god, that's
horrible. I can't believe those existed.
What?
Yeah, those existed.
Yeah, they existed.
Probably
the fish
like
would just die.
Videos and shit.
So that'd be really awesome for like a couple of days, and then you'd just be like.
Then horrifying.
Yeah, forever.
It'd be horrifying for a couple of weeks, but then after a couple of months, when like all the water turns cloudy with the dead bodies, then you couldn't see them anymore.
I mean, it wouldn't even if you kept them alive, it would turn cloudy. Fish are disgusting. It would go all like green and fuck. And shit.
Yeah, that's why they have those like third things in fish tanks.
There must have been a way for you to like to get them out or something, surely.
That sounds horrifying. There's so much wrong with that. For like, I can't imagine it would have like a you know like an air filter system, so like you couldn't pump air into it. They would suffocate. And like another thing is you're fucking walking. They'd be shaking around all over the place. They just instantly get stunned.
That's what I thought of.
So basically, what you're saying is, if you murder people in this life, you'll come back, be resurrected as a goldfish in a platform boot.
Yes, and you'll live a life that's like about an hour long.
Like I only killed 20 babies. That's it. In your next life, you're gonna be a goldfish. Oh, that's not too bad. In a platform boot.
What if a goldfish somehow managed to murder a person? Would they come back as a person?
What?
And assume the life force of that person that they murdered? Yes, the answer is yes.
Yeah.
Okay. What, like?
Ugh. I just found one of those platform shoes, but it has a spider in it instead of goldfish.
Alright.
Oh.
Also, how would a goldfish murder you? Please explain, Jake.
You're just having a little snooze in your fish tank, as you do.
Okay.
Actually, and it swims.
Okay.
It swims into your mouth, and it chokes you.
But wouldn't you be dead at this point anyway because you're underwater?
No.
No?
Oh, wait. I've got a better idea.
Yeah?
Because
I thought of one.
You are somehow, like, precariously, you know, it's got to be, like, some sort of ledge, or, like, you're very close to, like, falling off something, and the goldfish just gives you a little nudge.
My idea was that you're sleeping, and next to your bedside cabinet, there is a goldfish tank, and he just jumps out and down your throat.
Yeah, you could do that. Like Free Willy style, jump over the rocks.
And the fish wouldn't necessarily die instantly, but the human would. Therefore, the fish has murdered
instantly. Like, there's really no way a goldfish could kill you, is there?
I'm gonna Google it now.
What if you tried to eat it like in one gulp? I don't know, even then you could probably put it down your throat.
Like, if you tried to eat the goldfish, and it killed you.
Yeah.
That, like, you did that. It wasn't a goldfish.
So.
Yeah, there's no way.
People could buy goldfish.
There's no way. It'll have to, like, work its way up. It has to become a more powerful animal first.
It's level up, do some.
Yeah. It's gotta, like, kill, I don't know.
Well, what if.
Some other,
like,
fish.
You put a really sensitive button in the tank, and if it pressed that button, like, you were injected with
your
poison.
Your head blows up.
Yeah, your head blows up.
Technically, yeah, it would kill you. Okay, so I googled it, and it came up with a Yahoo, and Yahoo's the best for answers, okay? And it says, I was told that more people are killed by goldfish than sharks. And the answer is, if you're the kind of person that would believe that, you should get killed by a goldfish. Is this...
Do goldfish kill people?
Yeah.
Found it.
You found it, yeah?
What a dummy.
I mean, it's probably a reason why Magikarp is the most useless Pokemon.
Can a goldfish kill you?
Yeah.
I really want to know. There's got to be some way.
It must have been, like, someone was, like, swimming or whatever, and, like, a fish got caught in their mouth, and they choked to death on the water or something. Or maybe someone's allergic to fish or something, you know, like how people are allergic to nuts, and if you open a packet of nuts, they, like, blow up. Maybe someone's allergic to fish, and a goldfish just happened to, like, plop into their lap or something.
Well, that's, like, the same as choking on a goldfish. It's not really... The goldfish didn't... I don't know.
Yeah, like,
so
something that was wrong with you, it wasn't, like, the goldfish's fault.
Well,
it's gotta be the fault of the goldfish.
I don't think a goldfish can have murderous intent in them. So, therefore, a goldfish can't murder.
Yeah, I think that's...
Goldfish would have to deliberately...
What do you think a goldfish thinks about...
Probably, oh hi.
Who's he saying hi to, though?
He's saying it to himself in
the
reflection.
Does he even know? Does he even know that there's other fish around?
He's just talking to himself in the reflection, it's fine. Oh hi.
Yeah, but does he even know that it's him in the reflection?
Probably not, and it doesn't really matter because he forgets 7 seconds later anyway.
Yeah, they have, like, a really short memory.
Yeah, apparently. Although some people don't.
I mean, how do they know that, though?
Yeah, the...
How would you test that?
I feel like saying something like that, like the 5-second memory or whatever, that sounds like an urban myth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I think secretly, goldfish have, like, an IQ of, like, 160, and they're just fucking with you.
Yeah, they're like the rats or mice from
Oh yeah, Secret of Nim.
I was thinking, the fuck's that thing? Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Oh, right.
Oh, read that.
They're like the most intelligent creatures on Earth are actually mice. The second most intelligent creatures are dolphins.
I was going to say dolphins.
And the third are humans.
The dolphins, which rape.
Yes. And they also fly away from Earth when they know it's about to be destroyed.
Yep.
Dolphins fly away from Earth.
Man, that movie was cool.
Never saw that.
Yeah.
And now when I watch
it. One of the best scenes is when they go onto a planet and there's like shovels that hit them in the face in a couple of seconds.
It's not fair because when you guys watch the film, you really, really enjoyed it, right? But when I watch it, I'm going to go, oh, Alan Rickman's dead. No.
Nah, you'll be fine. It's still a good movie.
Well, who did he
He played play? The suicidal robot.
He played the robot with a huge head.
Oh, did he?
But like,
oh,
he just did the voice anyway. It's not like, it's just him. Going, but yes, I'll get that.
I watched
for
the movie
you.
Called Absolutely Anything, which stars what's his name, Nick Clegg or whatever the fuck his name is. I can't remember.
Nick Clegg.
Not actually Nick Clegg.
Wasn't that the Prime Minister?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But,
well, not. He was like some. He stars Vice Prime Minister. There's no such thing.
He starring Scotty
Miami
from Star
Vice
Trek.
Prime
whatever
Minister.
The fuck his name is.
That guy, Scotty from Star Trek. I don't know. He died.
No, he didn't die, but in that movie, Absolutely Anything, it stars the voice of Robin Williams, and I was like, oh, he's dead.
Oh, no,
right,
he
didn't.
Also, don't watch that movie,
it's bad. Oh, you mean Simon Pegg, the new
Simon
the
Pegg,
new
yes, Nick Clegg, Simon Pegg, same thing.
I thought you meant James Doohan, the original Scotty.
He's dead.
Yeah, he did.
He did.
Whales, Captain! Whales!
In fact, they're all dead apart from Kirk now, in fact, aren't they?
Isn't Uhura still alive?
Everyone's
and
dead.
George
she doesn't count, she's black.
George Takei. Wow,
what?
That's racist.
I'm joking, Jesus.
What do you mean?
Well, George Takei doesn't count then, he's yellow.
Yeah. No, there was an episode
and,
of Star Trek, the
Kirk
original...
Kirk doesn't count either, because he's Canadian.
Is he?
Yeah.
Oh. There was an episode in Star Trek, the original series, where Kirk kissed Uhura, but they had to do it so you couldn't see, so Uhura was, like, in front of the camera, facing away.
Oh, yeah.
Because apparently that was too risque.
Well,
that's
it was,
hilarious.
Like, 1967, so, like, people still weren't, like, okay with interracial marriage.
Oh, my.
Yeah, that was the
Wait,
one...
Wait, how do they feel about,
intergalactic
Kirk
marriage.
And the green alien.
Well,
yeah.
They're
yeah.
paid by white
they're
people, so it's
that.
Fine.
Yeah, that's so weird. It's like, well, Kirk can kiss a green lady, but a black lady? Ho-ho, no way.
I also love the fact that, and it's canon as well, in the original Star Trek and also in later Star Treks like Deep Space Nine and Voyager, that the evil dimension exists and they all wear beards.
Wait, Brock is here? What the fuck?
Remember
the evil
that?
Dimension where Spock like had a silly beard.
Yeah, had like a goatee.
That's really funny.
He should have
yeah,
a
they all had goatees.
That would have been great.
That was a funny episode actually.
Yeah. Several episodes in fact.
It.
And also Deep Space Nine touched on it too, I believe.
I gotta watch like some of the other Star Trek series.
I recommend TNG and Voyager. Deep Space Nine is alright.
You know who really pisses me off though is fucking what's his name? Data?
Oh?
Yeah?
Why?
Is that his name? I don't know, he just rubs me the wrong way.
Really?
Oh, is that when he tries to give you a handy and he's like rubbing it like the wrong way? What
and he's
the fuck
like,
are you doing?
Got his like fucking white face and I'm like, get your white face out
I
of
thought,
here.
I thought you were gonna say Worf because everyone doesn't like Worf. I mean, Jesus. Number of times.
Yeah, Worf's okay.
Someone did a supercut of all the times that Worf had a suggestion and Picard was like, no, let's do something else.
God, poor Worf. Worf. Close enough.
And there's also a supercut of Picard saying, shut up, Wesley.
God. Right, because I don't know about Star Trek, but did people like Wesley?
No, not really. He's annoying.
No. So, what's the deal with who played him?
I don't know.
The guy.
Know. Some kid.
He's like an
he's
internet
just a young
guy
dude.
Now.
Is he?
No, he's like, what's his fucking name?
Oh yeah, that's right. I remember that now.
Will Wheaton.
Yes.
Will Wheaton, right? Yeah.
Will Wheaton.
And, like, he's, like, an internet guy now. He's, like, a meme guy. He, like, does stuff on the internet. People are like, oh, it's Will Wheaton. Oh.
Yeah, Will Wheaton.
I don't understand why.
Who cares?
What did he do? What do you mean?
I don't know what he did, and I don't care.
Well, did he see that, I think it was, like, December last year, whatever, Will Wheaton did a post on Twitter or whatever, and he was like, he said, like, how he doesn't care about Wesley anymore and how people took the piss out of him and stuff. And, like, I don't care anymore. And then the first response was Patrick Stewart saying, shut up, Will.
I agree.
Like, you guys, I hope you guys don't watch Big Bang Theory, but I do. Because my family right. likes to watch it, so it's on TV.
I haven't seen
it for
ages,
like,
though.
Will Wheaton was in one of the episodes, and it was like...
Was the joke,
you know,
that he
was
Will
like,
Wheaton? Like, the joke was, it's Will Wheaton, and that's the joke.
Yeah, no, that was the thing. Everyone was like, oh my god, it's Will Wheaton, oh my god,
and he's
so
playing himself.
God, that's why that show is fucking answer. Like, Jesus Christ.
But I didn't understand, like...
I'm a nerd!
Is Will Wheaton? And I looked it up, and it's like this guy that everybody fucking hated. I don't... What? Trade with me, you bitch.
What are you trading?
Oh, we need to be at Pokemon Center? Oh, goddammit. Okay, hang on. Let's go to the nearest Pokemon Center. Come with me.
Oh,
go
me?
Go to the back of the parking lot.
Didn't Picard hate kids?
He disliked
them. Did he ever learn to love kids?
Yes. Yes.
Become a full-on pedophile?
In one episode, he actually grew up and had kids and stuff, yeah.
He grew up and became a full-grown man?
I'm in the Poké Center now.
He sprouted.
I'm going to the Pokemon Center, okay, I'm here.
What if one day somebody planted a seed in Trick Stewart's head?
Uh-huh.
Right? And like, cared for it every day, gave it sunlight, watered it, and it grew into a beautiful child. And then that was, he learned to love children.
Oh, God.
It happened. That's real life.
These are things that are happening in real life that you need to know about.
That's a great superhero.
Oh, shit,
right there.
You...
Press accept.
The ability
oh, shit,
to grow a child from a seed on your head, man.
There you go. Enjoy the star you. I would like him back when he's all grown up, please.
That might just be one level. Let me check.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to go back to the cave, but let me know if he levels up.
He's already like high level. I fucking hate Bulbapedia. It's so shit.
Then
where's
use
the
something
one?
Else, like
Pokemon
DB.
Database. Quite nice. Yeah. Fucking Bulbapedia is like, oh, you want to know about this Pokemon? Here is all of its appearance. Every episode ever. Here is all of its like names in other languages, and it's got like a list of like every single like manga appearance as well, and then. At the bottom of the page, it's got all the stuff you actually want to know about it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like hiding the fucking filthy video game material. They're like, God, those video games.
With water stone. Okay, I can do that.
You're gonna evolve my style, you have a water stone.
Yeah. Do I have any?
You have to go to Celadon to buy some. Is it Celadon?
Yeah. But I might have... Oh, I have two water stones. Well, what do you know?
What stats does that style you have? Because if it's good, I might not want you to evolve it. Ah, shit, whatever, fuck it.
Well, hang on, it went into the fucking Pokemon storage. Stupid. And there we go.
I think I saw the stats and they weren't that great.
It's got the highest attack and defense. But that's it. Everything else is average. It's got 31 attack and defense.
Defense is good, but attack, obviously not so good. Actually, that would actually be a pretty good Pokemon, oh shit. Man, whatever, evolve.
I don't think it's...
I'll live. I can get another one, or I'll cry or something.
Darmie is like a really shit Pokemon to fight with, anyway.
Okay, I'll come back to Poké Center now and trade back.
Alright. That's good. Me got two more Pokemon, now I just gotta evolve Bulbasaur.
Okay, I'm back in the Poké Center.
Alright.
Shit. Probably should have kept wing attack.
Oh yeah.
Fuck. Unless Brave Bird is in this game.
Hey, where are you?
I'm right here. Hi. I'm right here.
I see you now, okay.
Thank you. That was pretty good, actually, you know? I mean, I got a free evolution, I guess, but...
Nope. I'm going to get out... Something else I can evolve, which I think is Kabuto?
Oh yeah, Kabuto.
No.
Kabutops.
Listen, I don't care what people say, Kabuto is my god, okay? Fuck
Helix.
The other guy, I forgot his name. His name isn't Helix, it's like Almastar or something.
Yeah, but the Helix fossil. I haven't got my fossils changed yet.
Really? You should get that checked. Kabuto. No, I didn't. Oh, apparently Kabuto is also the name of that one guy from Naruto.
Yeah.
Fucking Orochimaru's handmaiden. I fucking remember this guy, that guy's name. I always forget his fucking name. Yeah. God, he's such a little bitch. So if I've only just gotten to the bit where that one teacher guy dies in Naruto Shippuden, how much more do I have to go?
Which teacher guy?
Well, like the one right at the start of Naruto Shippuden.
You've got a lot to go.
His name. Oh, really? Oh man, but I watched a few episodes of it. I was pretty far in. That's like what, 20 episodes? 50 maybe? That's fine.
Mm-hmm.
I'm almost there. I fucking watched 150 episodes of One Piece. It took so fucking long. And I want to like One Piece, but I'm just... You know, and like everyone gets excited about One Piece, and I want to be excited about One Piece. Do you ever feel like that, where everyone's into something that you're just not into, but you want to be into it? Because it seems like everyone's having a fun time with it, you know?
So it turns out that evolving Staryu that early is really, really bad. Oh well.
Oh yeah, why is that?
Because Starmie doesn't learn any moves apart from one.
Yeah, that's funny.
Apparently it starts with Hydro Pump, Rapid Spin, Recover, and Swift. So I don't know how it gets those moves, but. But yeah, evolving him that soon means he'll never learn, like, all these moves here. It's like, oh shit. Oh well.
Love Trader? I don't want Love Trader. Whatever. Right, I just need a few more Pokemon and I'll be there. Right, Diglett Cave. Back to... Victory Road.
Are you not
I'm gonna make it on Love Island.
Are you not gonna do any EV training? Oh, have you unlocked Love Island now?
I'm close. That's what I'm working on, unlocking Love Island.
Excellent. Can you catch me a ferry, please? Okay, thanks.
Sure. I'll get there and I'll tell you which ones are available.
Okay.
I think you can get Togepi. That's the one that I eyed up.
Yeah, Togepi because
I don't know how rare it is.
Yeah.
Probably pretty rare.
You've got to be, you can have a moveset which is really, really annoying, which I told you about before.
Yeah, but that's only really good against players. Real players, isn't it?
It's good against environment as well, I guess.
What does the AI do in Pokemon? Is it just random? It's always felt like it was just random.
Originally...
What the moves they fight.
In the original Red and Blue, whatever, it would use a move that was the type that was super effective against your Pokemon.
Really?
So, okay. If you used a fighting type and it had a psychic move, it would use it. Which worked fine until it had a move like agility, which was a psychic move, so it would just keep using agility. So that didn't work so well, so now it's a bit more random, I think, but yeah. But in the first Pokemon, one of the Elite Four has like an agility, and you can just like completely fuck it over by doing that.
That's pretty great. Fuck, what have I done?
So how many are you away now from getting to Love Island?
I'm stuck on this guy. Shit.
Oh.
I'm gonna have to re-log, you know what that means.
Disconnect from the internet.
Well, no, just like, the waiting queue.
Are you absolutely sure that you're... Can you not press escape and then press, like, go to main menu?
What do you mean? I logged out and I'm logging back in.
Okay. Are you in a queue? Please, don't let it be true. Also, yeah, Jake, did you want to do anything tonight, or are you busy doing maths?
I'm not too busy tonight.
Okay.
You want to do Viscera?
Oh, we could do some Viscera. I just figured since we're here, we might, you know, do something. So online gamers is still in chat. Yay! Also, Jake, I know the conversation's probably dead by now, but you never came up with a hero. What's your hero?
Oh, sorry, what?
Give me an idea for like a really lame superhero. It has to be like a really specific ability or whatever, though.
Fucks Heiach in the ass, man. Oh, he just like. He's fucking you in the ass.
No.
You know, you're up there on Justice Tower with him, and he's just fucking you in the ass, and the rest of them are, like, sitting around trying to discuss world politics, and you're just
like,
sitting there.
Would you keep it down over there, Heiach, and fucks Heiach in the ass, man.
And Heiach's just, like, crying. God, fucking, we're trying to save the world. You inconsiderate asshole.
I'm trying to take a shit right now, but I can't.
Trying to take a shit, man?
can't quite get it out, man.
How about the ability to teleport in any random direction 1 foot every week, man?
Every week? That's still pretty useful.
Yeah.
You know, if you knew when it was, then you can like...
It's only 1 foot, though.
But you can get into like a bank vault, right? But then you have to stay in there for a week.
Yeah, you have to be stuck in there for a week.
And they'd probably open it by that point, so what's the point, you know?
That just to let you out, really. They'd be like, how did you even get in there? And you'd be like,
I suppose it could be useful.
I can't tell you.
People for getting out of jail, I guess.
The ability to teleport in 1 foot. I'm pretty sure you'd have to teleport more than 1 foot to get out of a jail.
What, just go through the bars?
There's multiple bars.
Shut up.
It's not just the one bars.
Shut up.
You have to get through.
Look, back in the Old West, okay, it was just one set of bars.
Okay, the ability to travel back in time to the Old West and get out of jail.
the ability to teleport through old time prison bars, but only old time prison bars. No, that's newfangled stuff.
What a great ability.
How about the ability to make it sound like you've knocked on the door, but from a distance?
Like, basically just being a ventriloquist.
Yeah, but with a door. But only with doors. And knocking.
God, that sounds like aliens. They just make sound effects. Every time you hear, like, a spooky sound effect, it's just an alien.
It's useful, because, you know, imagine, like, you come into the front room, okay, and that douchebag is sitting in your seat again. And it's like, oh, fuck's sake. So you make it sound like the front door's been knocked on. They get up, they go to see who's at the front door, you get your seat.
Nice.
Actually useful.
Actually useful in very niche scenarios.
And for those situations where, like, someone's like, look, okay, I will never have sex with you unless someone knocks on that door right now.
That happens to me, like, all the time.
Yeah, I know, right? Oh, if it could be any door in the world, it could be one of those situations where, like, you're talking to someone online, and you're like, who's up behind you, and then you make the door knock, and they'd be like, oh, shit.
The ability to spook somebody online.
Oh, the ability to punch someone online would be great.
Like, through their monitor?
Yeah.
And that fist just comes out of their computer screen. I like the ability for your finger to transform into a random key. You don't know what that unlocks, though. But you can keep trying until maybe one of them might work.
That'd be cool. I mean, if I was in jail, you know, I'd just, like, try it, like, every couple seconds, you know. Just...
Why do you always go to jail?
Fuck you, okay?
Considering that you're in jail all the time? What have you been doing?
Because that's the best time to use these superpowers, apparently. Like... Can always find loose change, man. Be great in jail. Get loads of money.
But never more than 20p.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Some good Pokemon in here. How about the ability to have a lighter, but only when someone asks you for it? So someone can never use it when you need it,
only when other people
need
it.
Yeah, so they come up to your street like, oh, mate, you got a lighter, and you're like, no, yes, I do.
Wow, and then you go to, like, light up a smoke, but you don't have a lighter, no. So you have to ask him.
Oh, God. I wonder if Eve was muted again.
No, he just linked something that's probably really hilarious that I'm clicking on.
It's probably something about
an anime, or maybe a Bulbasaur.
What is it? Let's have a look.
Or Pikachu, maybe.
It... What?
Loading forever for me.
I'm not gonna look at that. That looks silly.
Trap waifus.
The fuck?
I really want to know more about, like... What is... I don't understand. What is going on?
It's a very good presentation. But how do you choose best girl?
Evil.
Yeah?
I thought Faint Attack was an attack that would reduce the Pokemon to one hit points and not die. Was that False Swipe?
That was False Swipe. Faint Attack is just some dark move.
Okay.
You kill something that was important.
No, I didn't.
No? Okay, that
no,
was
I, no, I didn't. I just thought, why is this guy still alive? Why isn't he alive, rather? That's fine. I did not anticipate how long it would take to EV train just one stat. Holy shit. At some point soon, we should stop doing this monotonous grinding and do something monotonous like cleaning a space station. Just swap one monotonous job for another. I wonder how Gamer is doing. Did he fight the berry trap tower? Did he succeed where I failed twice?
Did he find himself a trap waifu? They're different from regular waifus because they're actually males, but they look like females. Yeah.
You've activated my trap waifu.
Yeah.
Or like they're just a couple days under the age limit for sex or something.
Oh my god, that's not what trap is. Fucking normie.
I just explained to you what a trap was. By reading the slide on this very informative presentation.
That's a nice Electrovire, whatever he's called. Cool. So green names are members. What does it mean if someone's got like a symbol above their head? It looks kind of like a master ball.
They're masters.
They are masters. But yeah, now that Evil said it, I'm noticing a lot of things like this background. I'm pretty sure is custom made it to think it's actually a Pokemon background. I'm fighting a Diglett in a cave and it looks kind of like hand drawn. Looks kind of cool. Someone here's got a Budu, there's an Exeggutor running around. All these Pokemon apparently need high speed, I'm guessing. So, are you trying to like desperately evolve some more Pokemon so you can get to Love Island?
I'm trying to log back in, I'm in the queue.
Oh shit.
I'm at 500.
Oh fuck. I feel your pain.
It's not a big of a deal.
What are you in the queue? 500?
There's a lot of people that want to play this game and not enough slots.
What? Wow.
Yeah,
I think the limit at the moment is 1,900.
Yesterday I was waiting in queue for 45 minutes, Jake.
Why don't they just charge like a dollar each?
I think members can get in priority though, yeah, probably. I would have thought
$1 equals one like.
What, $1 equals one like, did you just say?
$1 equals one slot.
Okay.
That's not true, it's probably more expensive than that.
It's $5 to be a donator. And it's like a subscription thing, you have to donate $5
a month. For the fucking developers. Well, it probably costs more than $1 per slot. You know?
They have 1,900 slots last time I checked.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, they're probably paying quite a bit for it.
And they shouldn't be making money from this because it isn't their IP, but somehow they are, and they're not getting sued for it.
Well, because it's donations, not like proper transactions, but it is a transaction, so whatever.
So when I'm paying for being a member, I'm donating the money to be a member.
Yeah, and they're giving you like rewards for donating.
Uh huh.
It's like
I think that's how they get it, like get around it legally. But
and it's also because
if Nintendo wanted to, they could come down and shut it down like any moment.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think they're pretty lenient with Pokémon.
Pokemon.
Yeah,
it certainly didn't used to be. I remember like loads of MMOs used to get shut down when people were making them, but it doesn't feel like anymore. Oh my god, yes!
What?
You guys.
What?
Did you get back in?
No, he's found a link probably with a waifu.
He's
guessing.
Found a game. Oh, it's Hyperdimension Neptunia, you shouldn't unleashed. This is coming out in a week.
Yeah, oh my god.
Is it the multiplayer game you've been
Dynasty Warriors.
Week?
No.
Oh, then I don't give a shit.
The multiplayer game isn't even out in PlayStation 4 yet. I don't know what's happening with that.
Wait, so hang on a second. It's a multiplayer Neptunia game and it's PS4, both of which I don't have.
Yeah, but it will be coming to PC because all these games are being ported to PC now.
This doesn't even have like a genre.
Doesn't it? Oh yeah.
I think the genre for this game is.
Or is it actually a proper game? Oh, it's a proper game. Okay.
Yeah, it's genre
think
is.
There are any
There's no dating
Neptunia
sims for Neptunia.
Dating sims. No.
There fucking should be dating a dogu.
I'd love that if they came out with a dating sim, but you could only date the doggos.
Yeah.
Make it evil. You're a games developer.
Do it.
No.
Make all the games.
I don't make games anymore. It's fucking stupid. Games are stupid.
But your last game was a hit. It was like Game of the Year 2015, wasn't it, Jake?
Look, games.
Yeah,
are
and
children.
I caused like so many school shootings with that.
Yeah, just so much violence.
With interplanetary nunchucks, whatever the fuck it was. Planetary nunchucks.
Kids played that game and they just got enraged and they wanted to rape people online.
Hey,
and
hey guys, if you're
life.
Watching the stream right now, just go to IndieDB and check out Planetary Nunchucks. I think it's on there. Is it? I can't remember.
Who fucking knows anymore? Do they keep that stuff?
My stuff's still on there from a couple years back. I got some games.
Sorry, what? Say that? Yeah.
Like I said, my game. Game Jam and whatever their contests. Do they archive them?
If you put your game on the IndieDB,
yeah,
they'll
be there forever because they don't host the games and stuff. You have to host them and then link them to the Ludum Dare site.
Okay.
Can't remember what else I made for Ludum Dare. I made the nunchucks and I'd also just I did this weird thing, but like I was working with somebody else and they weren't. I mean, it's not really a serious thing.
It
doesn't really matter.
Is it like a
group
project at school?
But it was like on the last day they were like, oh yeah, I gave up.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
It's like a group project at school.
What do you mean?
I'm doing a group project with a guy today.
Yeah.
We're supposed to like have all this stuff ready. And I'm like, so I've got all this. And I was like showing him what I've done. And I'm like, so what have you done? He's like, I was just going to wing it. I was like, what? Like, I didn't know what to say. Like, what do you mean you're gonna wing it? Why? Yeah. That's how I feel about it. I feel sad.
Like, and you just kind of ask him, like, what do you mean like that? And he gets up in your face about it.
Yeah,
like,
and he's like,
you're the one being the asshole.
Like, I haven't done anything, so I'm just, I don't know. What
are you doing? Leave me alone.
Leave me alone.
Fucking.
I'm gonna call my
God,
dad.
Why do you have to be such a little bitch? God.
My dad owns a dealership. That's what he said to me. He told me that his dad owned a dealership, and then he took off in the spaceship.
And you were like, whoa, I'm glad I didn't mess with that guy. His dad owns a dealership.
Oh, that's cool.
What's up?
Rocket League is going to have cross-platform multiplayer across PlayStation 4 and Xbox One.
Really?
They've said that it's gonna happen.
Oh wait, no, with PC though.
They already have the inter-platform. Like PC players can play against, I think it's PS4 people.
Oh, okay, I see.
But now Xbox One is like, we want to join in the party.
I thought that was really hard to do. I mean, maybe it's changed. I remember Counter-Strike Go was supposed to be, or was for a time, cross-platform. But they had to drop it because, you know, they update Counter-Strike Go on the PC all the fucking time.
Yeah, like every week.
But it costs, like, loads of money, and, like, it's such a fucking ordeal to roll out updates on consoles that it didn't work out.
I think Rocket League probably doesn't do that, so it should. It's probably a good game to like try out with, right? I would assume.
I'm back.
That's cool. The other thing is like frickin', I don't know why Microsoft doesn't do more like PC and Xbox One cross-platform stuff since they own both of the platforms. You would have thought they would have done that earlier.
I guess, I mean, they don't really own...
They own Windows any... and DirectX, but like, I guess that's not a communication.
I guess DirectX, that's the point.
It's not like a communication protocol, though. Mm. They don't own the internet. I own the internet.
Do you think if I go to Al Gore's house, he'll let me borrow the internet for a bit?
No, he has it locked up in a safe.
Yeah. I stop by, I'm like, please, sir, can I have some net? And he's like, oh, okay, you little rascal, you. And he like, gives me...
Rubs your hair.
You go to Al Gore's back garden, you just see a series of tubes.
And I bring my little cup, and he takes a little teaspoon, he scoops out some internet, puts it in my cup.
You like peek over his fence, and like in his back his backyard, he has like the screensaver of pipes, but it's real. And yeah. That's the internet.
Whoa, that would be cool.
No, he just got a really bad case of worms. That's all.
He's got worms.
See, yeah, the worm virus. I did a callback to yesterday.
It's the pipe screensaver. That's the whole virus.
Yeah.
When I was in primary school, I couldn't get any work done because primary school work is like very hard. And also because they had like a computer, right, at the side of the classroom, and it would always go to favor mode and always do shit like the pipes and the maze and shit. And oh man, it was just so like I'd fucking lose myself, you
Did
know.
Did you have attention issues as a child? Ooh, look, no. Squiggly lines.
Your mom had attention issues.
My dad's better than your dad.
My dad's attention issue. Your dad.
Holy shit. I don't know if I can be bothered to AV train any other Pokemon apart from this one. This is taking so long.
Oh, fuck off. Fucking who are saying, oh, Sips likes the noise of the water bottle. And I'm like, yeah, I like the noise of the water bottle. So this
what,
guy's
you mean
like
the filling up of the water bottle?
Yeah. This guy's like, oh, that means he has ASMR. I didn't even know that was like a thing you could have.
It's like a disorder.
Yeah. Is this something he did in the Subnautica videos I'm not watching?
Yeah, there's like listen. He gets a special bass filtration thing and like it filters water for him, and when it makes a new water it spawns the bottle and then fills it up with water and it makes that noise of like the pitch changing.
Oh, that sound.
Yeah, as the bottle fills up. Yeah.
I thought you meant the sound like when you squeeze a button it goes like
oh.
You mean like if you take like an empty water bottle and then you like crack it and it sounds like bones cracking?
Not quite what I meant, no, but no, that's fine.
And then you can like trick somebody into thinking you like cracked your bones.
If they're dumb.
By like, yeah. No, it works, trust me.
Oh, really?
On dumb people.
Hey Jake. Got your nose.
You don't have my nose.
It's
you
right
can't
here, look.
Have
See?
It.
See, look.
It's through
right
the
here.
Internet, you need to be... have the ability to reach through the internet and steal someone's nose, man.
Look, okay. I'm punch person through internet, man, okay? I can do anything.
Convince somebody that you actually have their nose, man.
can you remember that on, like, Human Framed when, like, the kid would cry because someone took their nose?
Yeah, like babies.
Wasn't that, like, 4 or 5 years old?
Babies. Stupid baby. You push him over.
Yeah, you're right though, chat is just so much spam. It's people like, hey guys, rate my Magnemite. Hey guys, is this a good Charizard? I don't fucking know.
I think you just need to take a step back and listen to the sound of pure high-quality H2O being dispensed.
I want to hear that now. You have to let me know which episode, and I'll watch that one episode.
I think he's done it in, like, every episode since, like, 10 or whatever. At least once.
What we need, what's his name? Zibbit, whatever his name is. We do, like, Pimp My Pokemon. We can get...
Zibbit?
Yeah, can you imagine, like, an Onyx, but wearing, like, a pimp hat or something?
No, it would have to be, like, he has, like, a juice machine and, like, really small TV somewhere. You know, they always put fucking TVs everywhere that were really small.
It always has to be, like, Inception, though. It's like, we heard you like TV, so we put a TV in your TV and gave you another TV.
Yeah. And, like, they put popcorn machines and, like, stupid shit that, like, you wouldn't want in a car, you know?
Yeah. It's like, we hear that you like cleaning shoes, so we've adjusted the brake pedal to clean your shoe whenever you push the brake. It's like, oh, what? I don't know.
See, that would be good. It would be like they just put a shoe polish machine in your trunk, so you have to, like, get out of your car and, like, put your shoes in there. It's just very inconvenient. Why would you want that in your car, Exhibit? Tell me.
Also, guys, if you ever have a baseball bat in the boot of your car, have a baseball glove as well. Your lawyer will thank you.
Yeah?
Yeah. Just random fact there, life facts. Life facts of Heiach, 2016.
I'm trying to find, like, the dumbest Pimp My Ride cards now.
And I'm just going to be wondering if Evil's, like, dead again.
Yes.
Because he mutes himself quite often.
No, I just haven't said anything. I hope that's okay, I'm sorry.
He pisses them off when I mention it as well. I'm sorry, Jesus. I get worried, okay? Because you could be saying some top quality shit and we're missing it.
Listen, we're talking about me. I don't say anything of interest.
Talks about, like, trap waifus and that's about it.
Fucking trap waifus.
Listen, I'm browsing the game industry subreddit and there's a lot of porn today. So I got a lot of stuff to get through.
There's a lot of porn today. Got a lot of porn.
I was just looking at anime IRL because it is pretty funny.
Oh yeah.
And there was one that was like... Oh, what was it? It was like, I never met my parents. They died a year before I was born.
What was that thing from Sleepy Cast or whatever it was?
You mean the thing that Birdie said? Where when I was 6 years old, yeah. I was born without a face?
Yeah, that. When I was 6 years old, I was born without a face. Like, what?
I think that's something the Game Grump said. Oh, Aaron was trying to prove that he could, like, talk and tell... He could play a game and tell a story at the same time.
That was right.
And that was the story he told. Clearly demonstrating the point that he can't do that.
Is it? Actually, I was gonna say, am I dumb? The answer to that question is yes, I am dumb, because it took me about 5 episodes before I realized that Aaron, the guy who sounds like shit. See, I can't remember the name now, but you know what I mean. You know I'm going with that.
No. What does Aaron sound like?
He sounds like Jeff from Sleepy Cast. Like the first few episodes of Sleepy Cast I listened to, I thought he sounded a lot like Aaron. But I don't know who you were gonna say he sounded like. He probably sounds like a lot of people.
Hang on, I need to check Google because I'm being dumb. There we go, there it is, yeah. So yeah, I was watching Game Grumps and I was listening to it and I thought, that Aaron guy, he sounds a lot like Ego Raptor.
Wow.
It's like,
Good job.
I know. It's like, he sounds a lot like Ego Raptor, in fact, and I got like a few episodes in, I'm like, oh.
What do you know? It's Ego Raptor's dad. Clearly, it's his dad.
What, Ego T-Rex?
No, Ego Chicken.
Ego Chicken, of course.